Well, we're one of the first. This is a rapidly growing area.
This year we actually had to cap the courses. It's a huge interest for our students in aviation.
UAS stands for Unmanned Aircraft or Aerial System. It started back in 2007, shortly after the Greensburg tornado. It was a bad year for disasters in the state that year. And the Guard was also deployed, and when Greensburg happened, the town, of course, was devastated, and the National Guard was short on assets. And so at that time, there was a call for the ability to put an eye in the sky without necessarily putting a person in the sky.
There's a lot of different ways that the UAVs or RPAs, whatever you would like to call them, are used. And there's three things that you can look at a UAV and say it'd be good for. If they call it the three D's in our industry: dirty, dull, and dangerous. In a disaster, you have both dull and dangerous and dirty. So the dull side is a lot of these incident commanders or the generals that need to make the decisions need that eyes on, and they need it for a long time. So the constant stare of being able to say, all right, now I need to go look at where the hospital is, what's the route that the ambulances need to take to the hospital because this is blocked off. With this aircraft, for 20 hours, we could stay aloft and give that information back and forth.
So on board the aircraft is an autopilot, and that's basically the brains of the aircraft. So that autopilot, you pre-program in your pre-flight of the aircraft. You put a flight plan in there for the mission that you're actually going to fly. So you can have that all set up before you even get to wherever you're going to fly. And then once the aircraft is in the air and tracking that flight plan, you can interact at any time. And that's why it's called remotely piloted, because it is autonomous until the pilot wants to interact. The technology on these aircraft is much more advanced than just an RC aircraft. An RC aircraft is a pilot with a transmitter in his hand that's transmitting data just to the aircraft, and the aircraft is responding to. And like I said, that's been used by hobbyists for years. An unmanned aircraft has information being sent to the aircraft as well as the aircraft sending information back to the ground station.
The certificate program is more for somebody that already has a bachelor's degree and has a private pilot's license already. For example, an enlisted soldier just getting out of the military, a furloughed airline captain or first officer that wants to get into a different faucet of aviation. So they can come in and basically in two semesters get a certificate, learn how to fly these vehicles, and learn the history and the rules that are involved in it. And go out and then seek employment from there. The bachelor's program is actually a major that they come and they learn both manned aviation through their commercial or through their private and instrument license and their UAS. The job market is wide open for students seeking careers in this right now. If a student wants to go work for a manufacturer or a contractor, a military contractor, if they're in the United States, they're looking to start out around $60,000 to $65,000 a year straight out of university. Or if they want to do deployments to work for a contractor, they're upwards of $150,000 a year for 4 month deployments a year. So it's a very lucrative career field for these students.